This is Egypt's new furniture city. The industrial park lies outside of Damietta, a port city that was at the center of a once flourishing but now declining furniture trade. To help revive the sector, the government has spent $230 million to create hundreds of workshops and space for dozens of factories.
The idea for the furniture city came after the government's initiative to rely more on local production and decrease reliance on imports while increasing exports to international markets.
The project also aims to create 100,000 jobs in a country where one in three people live in poverty. The unemployment rate is at around 8%. But so far, only a third of the newly built workshops have been sold, with just a few up and running. Many craftsmen say the cost of $20,000 to be paid over 10 years is too high and the distance to the new hub too far.
You've seen our neighborhood here. Our houses are above our workshops. There is not a worker among us who will go to that city over there.
The craftsmen say the new park is lacking the authentic feel of Damietta's historic quarter, where workshops line narrow streets amidst sawdust and the smell of wood. Officials say the old city's 30,000 workshops will remain open, while producers will be trained in the new park.
Those who suffer today are the smaller businesses, the ones who make everything with their own hands. These are the ones who need attention in the coming period.
Famed for crafting ornate and gilded pieces resembling French furniture of the 18th century, Damietta's craftsmen have been a favorite among Egyptians for many decades. But changing tastes, cheaper imports from Turkey and China, and lower consumer spending have hurt the industry in the past 30 years. And that means a lot is depending on the new furniture city's fate. If successful, it will serve as a model for other sectors, with similar parks planned in more than 24 provinces. Sibel Karkus, TRT World.